Two men have now been charged and a third is still in custody in connection to the mass shooting over the weekend at a bar in St. Paul.
It appears the shooting started between two of the suspects with all the other victims caught in the crossfire.
We have live team coverage of the shooting and the aftermath, including loved ones sharing memories of the woman killed in the shooting, reaction from people there that night, and St. Paul leaders. Plus, what the future holds for the busy stretch of West 7th where the shooting took place.
Danny Spiewak will have more on that in a moment, but we begin with Janelle Klein live in St. Paul with the new information we've learned about the suspects and what happened that night. Janelle?
Randy and Julie, prosecutors wasted no time in filing their criminal complaint, and now two men face criminal charges. Devondre Phillips faces 12 counts of attempted murder, and Terry Brown faces 11 counts of attempted murder, as well as the intentional murder of Markeisha Wiley.
This cell phone video was the first look inside Sunday's shooting, but a criminal complaint filed late today now gives details of how and why it happened. Charged are 33-year-old Terry Brown and 29-year-old Devondre Phillips, with a third man arrested who hasn't been charged. The complaint says Brown told police he had an ongoing argument with Phillips over domestic abuse allegations between Brown and his girlfriend, saying Phillips walked up and shot him and he fired back. The charges say the men then continued to fire rounds at each other across the crowded bar.
It was an argument over a woman, and not necessarily a person that was even inside the bar.
The complaint says bullets were still flying when Phillips ran outside while bystanders jumped on Brown and punched him until he dropped the gun. It says Phillips now claims he doesn't remember what happened, but says surveillance cameras show exactly how the fight occurred.
This was an argument that had been pending for a while, and one person pulled a gun and the other retaliated.
Those shots led to the nearly instant death of 27-year-old Markeisha Wiley, who police say was struck in the back, then carried outside over someone's shoulder. Officers say Wiley at first had a faint pulse that quickly disappeared, and she was gone just 11 minutes after shots rang out. And still inside were 14 others injured in the crossfire. Ranging in age from 21 to 36, they were hit in the feet, arms, stomach, hands, legs. Many still hospitalized and now each referenced by their initials in 11 counts of attempted murder against both Phillips and Brown. Police say everyone there that night will live with what they witnessed.
Everyone inside that facility, and I've talked to several, is traumatized by the screaming and the shooting, and it's going to take some time for them to recover from what they went through.
Well, both of the men have extensive criminal histories and neither is allowed to legally possess a firearm. Both of the men remain hospitalized tonight, Randy and Julie, with injuries sustained in yesterday's shooting. Back to you.
Well, loved ones and community members gathered at Raspberry Island in St. Paul for a vigil tonight to share memories and light candles honoring the life of the woman killed in the shooting, Markeisha Wiley, also known as Kiki. The 27-year-old is described as a kind young woman with the biggest heart who had her whole life ahead of her. She worked as a vet technician for about 7 years, most recently at Invergrove Heights Animal Hospital. Friends say Kiki was a good friend to many, who was always looking out and standing up for others.
It's cliche, but she had that personality and that smile that when she walked into a room, it was just enlightening. She just glowed inside and out. She was stunning. You couldn't help but notice her.
There's a GoFundMe page set up to help Wiley's family with funeral expenses. We have a link on our website.
That shooting happened during a busy night out on West 7th, a corridor that's full of bars and restaurants. Danny Spiewak is live now with what this tragedy could mean for that area. Danny?
Well, Julie, 7th Street Truck Park plans to stay closed in the coming days, according to ownership, but they also plan to fully reopen here at some point on West 7th, which is now trying to chart a path forward after this mass shooting.
As the clock approached midnight, 7th Street Truck Park overflowed with customers.
It was just a little too packed in there.
So Tracy Blue moved next door 10 minutes later.
Just heard a really loud noise and people started running down the streets and just screaming. It was quite terrifying.
A block away, the noises rattled Tom Reed's.
The minute we heard, we locked our doors.
General Manager Kathy Gossiger and other business leaders had already struggled through COVID before this weekend's mass shooting.
It's not just the shooting, it's everything. All these businesses have worked so hard to get to where they are.
In response, the St. Paul Downtown Alliance has quickly deployed street team members to secure West 7th. Plus, St. Paul Police and Ramsey County Sheriff Bob Fletcher have boosted patrols.
We do want to make sure this doesn't occur again, and it's going to take some commitment out of our city and county leaders to make sure that happens.
With concerts back at the X and the Wild opening their regular season schedule later this month,
this is our neighborhood.
People like Rick Furkus say they're not leaving.
When something like this happens, you're going to be more aware of the presence around you. But I think people, they're going to be strong.
Still, the trauma will linger for those who experienced the shooting.
I had the shakes all morning just thinking about it and what if, and our friends. It won't stop us from going back to the places. We want to support the neighborhood, but just different, maybe different hours.
I also want to mention that United Hospital is just a couple of blocks away from where this shooting happened. And of course, you'll often see healthcare workers walking on the West 7th corridor throughout the day and evening. We got a statement from Alina Health that operates United. They say that they're working with community leaders and community organizations to ensure the safety of this street. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Danny. St. Paul Mayor Melvin Carter led a moment of silence for Kiki Wiley and all victims and survivors of gun violence at an event for Indigenous Peoples Day tonight.
I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge that this celebration happens at a time in which our St. Paul family is hurting, in which our St. Paul family is in mourning, is in pain.
Well, in reaction to the shooting, St. Paul Police Chief Todd Axtell is calling out judges for giving too many second chances to violent offenders. He says the common denominator in many shootings is that the offenders are felons who aren't supposed to carry a gun anymore.
But we need to draw a line somewhere. And people who, again, aren't getting it, aren't, accepting the help, people who continue to use violence with weapons that they shouldn't be allowed to carry, need to be held to account, unapologetically. Because when I talk to the Wiley family, again, it's personal when you hear that pain and you feel the pain.
Stay with Care 11 for any developments on the St. Paul shooting. As we learn them, we'll bring them to you on air and all of our digital platforms.